Anatomy, physiology, what does that mean? Simply put, anatomy equals structure, physiology equals function. We're gonna learn about structures and their function. Wait a minute, what's going on? I'm already short, stop, stop, stop! Oh, wait, I know what's going on. I'm supposed to introduce you to our first concept. Well, let's start first with my size. I'm the size of an atom. Cells are made up of atoms. Tissues are made up of cells. Organs are made up of tissues. Organ systems are made up of organs. And organ systems make you and me. You've just learned the levels of organization from smallest to largest, but make sure you know them from largest to smallest as well. Let's talk about the levels of organizations a little bit. Organ systems. There are 11 of them, and from August to May, you're going to learn each and every one. Number one, integumentary system. Your skin is similar to a coat. It covers your body from head to toe. You know, I actually have a song about the integumentary system. You should check it out. Number two, nervous system. Signals are moving all throughout my body. You know, I actually have a music video about the nervous system. You should check it out. Number three, endocrine system. You're a teenager. Sassy, moody. Oh, sorry. What I meant to say is during this age, there are a lot of hormones running through your body. Endocrine system. Number four, skeletal system.
Cindy! This is a skeleton! This is bones!
And you have 206 bones in your body. Here's a sneak peek of some of those bones you're going to learn later on this year. Number five, muscular system. Number six, cardiovascular system, otherwise known as the circulatory system. You know, I have a video about that too. You should go and check that out. Number seven, lymphatic or immune system.
Achoo!
Bless you.
Achoo!
Coronavirus! Coronavirus!
You know, I actually have a song about COVID-19. You should go and check that out. Number eight, respiratory system. You know, I actually have a song about the respiratory system. You should go and check it out. Number nine, digestive system. I think it's about time that I eat something. But before I do that, you should go check out my song about the digestive system. You'll really enjoy it. Number 10, urinary system. Excuse me one moment. Number 11, reproductive system.
Body parts and body regions.
Hun, I think it's time for us to have the talk. not only do we talk about organ systems, but you also have to know anatomical positions as well. Everything that is on that orange card, you need to know for my class. It would be a really great idea if you get creative with how you learn anatomical positions. For example, I dial digits with my digits. Or orbital for eyes, because I can move my eyes in an orbit. I really can't wait to see what you guys come up with. They have to be much better than that. After watching this video, you need to practice saying femur versus thigh, frontal versus forehead. This also applies to directional terms. We don't say front, we say anterior. And we don't say back, we say posterior. This chart has the commonly used directional terms, and most are straightforward. So I'm going to focus on the terms that give my students the most problems, year after year. First up, proximal distal. For starters, the terms proximal and distal are used for your appendages, your arms, and your legs. Let's start with the word proximal. When I hear the word proximal, I think of the word proximity, closer. And when I hear the word distal, I think of the word distance, further, at a distance. Like I said before, we use these terms for your appendages. So we are determining which point of attachment is closest or further from the center of the body, otherwise known as your torso. Your body is actually the perfect visual reference when trying to understand the words proximal and distal. I'm going to use the leg and arm as an example. Stretch your arms out in front of you. Look at your shoulder. That's the closest point of attachment. And then look at your palm. That's the furthest point of attachment. Remember, we are focusing on our torso. Ask yourself, is one point of attachment closer than another point? For example, are your fingers closer to your torso than your elbow? No. So we would say the fingers are distal to the elbow. They are further away from your torso than your elbow is. The elbow is proximal to the fingers because the elbow is closer to the torso. These points of attachments will always be closer to the torso because, well, they're attached to the torso. Let's look at another example with the arm. Your shoulder and your elbow. The shoulder is to the elbow. Guess proximal, you are right, because the shoulder is in closer proximity to the torso when compared to the elbow, which is further away. That means the elbow is distal to the shoulder. Last example, your leg. Come on, it's time for you to show off. The ankle is to the knee. If you guess distal, you are right, because the ankle is further away from the torso when compared to the knee, which is much closer. How about this one? The hip is to the knee. You should have guessed proximal. The hip is in closer proximity to the torso when compared to the knee, which is further away. All right, the final topic for today is body planes. We have sagittal, frontal, transverse. Let's start with sagittal. Of or relating to an arrow, resembling an arrow, furnished with an arrow-like appendage. When you hear the word sagittal, you need to think about the long axis of the body. The sagittal plane divides the body into left and right. The sagittal view is the side view of the body. Think of Sagittarius, an archer, and how the archer holds that bow in the sagittal plane. Make sure you know the difference between sagittal and mid-sagittal. Both divide the body into left and right. Sagittal is going to be off-centered, whereas mid-sagittal is right down the middle. The coronal or frontal plane divides the body into anterior and posterior. You may be thinking, why is it called a coronal plane? Coronal. This term is derived from Latin corona, garland, crown, or from ancient Greek, garland, wreath. For the coronal or frontal plane, it more or less corresponds to the plane defined by the frontal bone. If you wear a garland or a crown, that's where it sits. Lastly, we have the transverse plane or the horizontal plane. This plane divides the body into its superior and inferior parts. To remember it, let the name help you out. The prefix trans means across. Think of transatlantic airlines flying you across the Atlantic Ocean. For a transverse plane, it doesn't have to be equal top and bottom halves. Any separation of the top and bottom is a cut along the transverse plane. Well, why is it called horizontal? Well, let's jump on over to math for a minute. X and Y lines, horizontal and vertical. Horizontal lines go across, just like the horizontal plane. Let's recap what we've talked about. Levels of organization, 11 human body systems, anatomical positions, directional terms, and body planes. I hope this helped, and I'll see you soon. Science G, signing out.